Good afternoon to all of you. My name is Dr. Rajni and I'm assistant professor in Department of Agriculture of NIMS University. Today I'm going to take a topic that is introduction to horticulture. In horticulture, basically I'm going to take the lecture about the definition, what are the definition. Second, the branches of horticulture, what are the different branches of horticulture I'm going to take. Now coming to this first, what is the definition of horticulture? Basically, horticulture, it is made up of two Latin words, and those Latin words are hortus plus cultura. Hortus means garden and cultura means cultivation. Now, what is the meaning of horticulture? The meaning of horticulture is cultivation of garden is known as horticulture. Now, comes to the definition portion. What is the definition of horticulture? Horticulture, basically, it is a branch of agriculture in which we study about the fruits, vegetables, flower, and the aromatic plants, medicinal plants, plantation crops. All these things comes under this horticulture portions. Now, coming to this branches portion, what are the different branches of horticulture? In horticulture, basically, different branches are there. The first branch in horticulture is pomology. In pomology, basically pomology, it is also made up of two words. And the first word is pomum. And the second word is logus. It is made up of two words, that is pomum and logus. What is the meaning of pomum? The meaning of pomum is fruit and the meaning of logus is study. Pomology is one term which is made up of two words. The one word is Latin word and the second word is Greek word. It is made up of two words, that is one is Latin and another one is Greek. The meaning of pomum is fruit and the meaning of logos is study. Now, what is the meaning of pomology? It's a study of fruit is known as pomology. And what is the definition? Means pomology, it is a branch of horticulture in which we study about the fruit. Now, coming to the next branch, that is olericulture. Olericulture. Olericulture, it is made up of two Latin words. Any word which is end with culture, that means it's a Latin word. Okay, so olericulture, it is made up of two Latin words. The one is olerus and the another one is cultura. The meaning of olerus is vegetables and the meaning of cultura is cultivation. Now, what is the meaning of olericulture? The meaning of olericulture is cultivation of vegetable is known as olericulture, or we can say olericulture, it's a branch of horticulture in which we study about the cultivation of vegetables is known as olericulture. Now coming to the next branch, that is floriculture. Floriculture, it is also end with the culture, that means it's a Latin word. It is made up of two Latin words. The one is florus and the another one is cultura. Now, what is the meaning of florus? In case of florus, what is the mean in case of floriculture? What is the meaning of florus? The meaning of florus is flower and the meaning of cultura is cultivation. Now, the meaning of floriculture is cultivation of flower is known as floriculture, or we can say floriculture, it's a branch of horticulture in which we study about the flower, or we can say we can study the cultivation of flower. Now, coming to the next branch, that is spices and condiments. Spices and condiments, it is also a branch of horticulture in which we study about the spices. For example, spices means For example, the study of black pepper, study of cardamom, study of cinnamon, that is comes under this horticulture. That is comes under this spices and condiments, which is a branch of horticulture. Coming to the next branch, that is plantation crop. Plantation crop, it's a branch of horticulture in which we study about the plantation crops like coffee, like tea. We study, we used to study about the production technology of this coffee, tea, etc. Next branch of horticulture, that is production, that is basically medicinal and aromatic plants. Medicinal and aromatic plants. In medicinal aromatic plants, what is this aromatic and medicinal plant? It's a branch of horticulture in which we study about these medicinal aromatic plants. Like we study, we used to study about the aloe vera, like aromatic plants like like aloe vera. Second is like periwinkle, like sarpagandha, ashwagandha. We are studying in medicinal and aromatic plants. Next, that is next branch is nursery management. What is nursery? Here the question is, what is nursery? In case of nursery, it's a small area where rearing and caring of a small plant is done. That is known as nursery. Nursery, basically it is made near to the house or near to the market. Second, how will prepare nursery? Basically, the length of the nursery is about 3 to 5 meter, and this length can be increased or decreased as per the availability of land, as per the requirement of the farmer. The width of the nursery is 1 to 1.5 meter. This width will not increase because the distance between two nursery is 35 to 45 centimeter, and if the width is too large, then there is a difficulty in cultural operation. That's why the width should be 1 to 1.2 meter. Now, what is the height of this nursery from the ground level? The height of the nursery is 15 centimeter, not more than this. Okay. Basically, nursery, it is prepared in two method, like flat nursery bed is there, and the second one is raised nursery bed. In raised nursery bed, the height of the nursery is 15 centimeter from the ground surface. These are the branches of horticulture and basically the definition of horticulture. Now coming to the next topic, that is production technology of tomato. What is tomato? What is the botanical name of tomato? The botanical name of tomato is Solanum lycopersicum. Earlier, the name of tomato is Lycopersicum esculenta, which is changed from 2006 by Perlet and Spooner, who changed this botanical name of tomato, that is Solanum lycopersicum. The family of tomato is Solanaceae. The chromosome number of tomato is 24. Basically, in Solanaceae family, there are 5 members. The first one is tomato, second is brinjal, third is chili, capsicum and potato. Except potato, all the Solanaceae member having 24 chromosome number. Except potato, what is the chromosome number of potato? It's a 48. Because potato, it's a tetraploid in nature. So, the chromosome number of potato is 48. Now, what is the origin of tomato? It's a Peru and Bolivia region of South America. It's a center of origin of tomato. Now coming to the climatic condition of tomato, which type of climate is suitable for the cultivation of tomato? Basically, tomato, it's a warm season crop, and it for the cultivation of tomato, the climate, the temperature is near about 25 to 35 degree centigrade temperature we can grow tomato. But there are some varieties are also available which can be grown in 8 degree centigrade temperature, that is Pusa Sheetal. Pusa Sheetal is the variety of tomato which we can propagate in a low temperature. For lycopene content, what is lycopene? Lycopene is basically, it's a pigment which is responsible for the red color in tomato. So for the cultivation of tomato, lycopene is a main factor. We just focus on the lycopene content, because lycopene, it is basically fluctuate, the pigment of lycopene, it is fluctuate with the rise in temperature. So the best temperature for the cultivation of tomato for lycopene production, that is 21 to 24 degree centigrade. It is the best temperature for the development of lycopene in tomato. If the temperature is more than 30 degrees, more than 27 degrees centigrade and less than 10 degrees centigrade, then the lycopene content, that is decreasing. Okay. But if the temperature further come in the range of this 21 to 24 degrees centigrade, then there is a further development of the lycopene. If the temperature goes above 40 degrees centigrade, then lycopene content is completely destroyed. Okay. So the best temperature for the development of lycopene in tomato, that is 21 to 24 degrees centigrade. Next, that is soil. In which type of soil we can propagate this tomato? Basically, tomato, it can grow in all type of soil. But if the sandy loam to clay loam soil is best for the cultivation of tomato. If we want early crop, then we should go for early crop. We should grow for the light soil. And if we want high yield, then we should choose the heavy soil. This is the character. This is basically used for the all crops. In case of tomato, basically sandy loam to clay loam soil is best for the cultivation of tomato. Now, what is the pH? pH is important factor for cultivation of all the crops. In case of tomato, the pH should be 6 to 7. This is the best pH in which we can propagate the tomato. Now, coming to the next, that is seed rate. Basically, in case of tomato, the seed rate for open pollinated varieties and the seed rate of hybrids, that is different. Basically, for open pollinated varieties, the seed rate is 400 to 500 gram per hectare. And for hybrids, the seed rate is less, that is 125 to 175 gram per hectare. Means 125 to 170 gram seed is enough for the cultivation of 1 hectare area. As I told you, it's a warm season crop. Then the season is, in case basically if you want to propagate the crop in June to July, you can propagate in June to July, and the September, October, it's also we can cultivate the tomato. There are the number of varieties in tomato. For example, I just told you earlier that the Pusa Sheetal, it's a variety which is we can propagate in a low temperature. Pusa Hybrid 1, it's a variety we can propagate in a little bit high temperature. Like Pusa Sadabar, we can propagate in low as well as high temperature. There's a number of varieties in tomato. Pant Bahar is there. And in case of tomato, basically the first thing which we should take care, that is the red color. Okay, so red color, that is basically due to the lycopene content, and the best temperature for the cultivation of lycopene, it's a 21 to 24 degree centigrade. So this is all about the tomato, cultivation of tomato. Thank you.